Thank you for tuning in to the worship service of Union Chapel Missionary Baptist Church, a church with a big heart of love. Located at 315 Winchester Road in Huntsville, Alabama, under the leadership of Dr. Owendell Davis. The worship services begin at 7:45 a.m. and 10:45 a.m. every Sunday. Now, we pray that you are blessed by our worship experience.
Oh, Bye. Oh. People are dying slowly every day. The enemy's trying, attacking every way he can.
We gotta fight, we gotta fight, we gotta fight.
You see, in this generation, materialistics swallow the minds of these innocent children, yeah.
We gotta fight, we gotta fight, we gotta fight.
Oh, you see the fame and the drugs, the money, the lust, the violence, the hatred, and we must plead the blood of Jesus. These church folks are leaving, cause they're so confused about these wrongfully teachings, making a bad name for all of us Christians.
So many saints are holding unforgiveness.
We got nation against nation, earthquakes in various places, people living in famine, everyone's losing patience. This is a war cry that everyone needs to hear.
Thank you. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. War. In the name of Jesus, amen. We give our profound reverence to our Lord and to our God again, to our worship leader today, Minister Savage, to the rest of the ministers, to our leadership, mothers, members, and friends. I would like to call your attention to Proverbs chapter 4. And let me read verse 23 and 24. And here is what it says in the King James Version. Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Put away from thee a forward mouth and perverse lips, put far from thee. You may be seated. I've been led to preach from this subject today. 5 days. And I see you. 5 days. The older I get, the more I find myself preaching from personal experience. And most of my preaching now is testimonial preaching, even though it remains pastoral. I'm a firm believer that you can't lead people to a place you've never been. You're right, it took a while, but the Lord in his own time has shown me the path to restoration. And the more I think about it, I think about 2 days on the first trip, 5 days on the second trip to Huntsville Hospital. First trip took me not knowing what was happening to my body. And I spent 2 days in ICU. And then they put me in a room. Came home for a week and was rushed back with excruciating pain running from the middle of my spine all the way up into my chest. Had fluid on my lungs. And they were talking pneumonia and everything else, vital organs shutting down. And I thought I was on my way in. But all God was doing was laying me down in green pastures so that he could reinforce his shepherdship so that he could readjust my heart to let me know that if I keep my heart with all diligence, because without a good heart, it's impossible to deal with the issues of life. With all of the trouble we're having out of White House and Congress, politicians afraid to speak truth to error, I wonder sometimes if your election to Congress is more important than your eternal abode. And the way some folk are acting, they think that this is home, but it's not home. We're just passing through here. God is making us ready to inherit our eternal home. They did what's called a CT scan on the second trip. And the excruciating pain came as a result of a torn aorta. And from what I understand, medical people, y'all can help me out. That's the main artery. The blood shoots up and flows into your heart. And if that rips or tears, you don't have long to be here. One doctor explained it to me. It's only a matter of seconds. If it rip enough, you can pack your bags. And in the midst of struggling and fighting to breathe, pneumonia setting in and all kind of stuff happening. I've never been in the hospital as an adult and didn't know how to be sick. But God set me aside for a moment and helped me to get my heart back in order, so I could deal with the issues of life. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. You can't have faith in something that you don't understand. And what God will do for all of us from time to time, it may not be ICU for you. It may not be intensive care. Could be right there in your home. But God has a strange way of making us lie down in green pastures. Shepherd Psalm says, he in green pastures he restores our soul. He is a heart fixer, brothers. He is a mind regulator. You can think that that's cliche if you want to, but it's truth. And if we had leaders who would allow the Holy Spirit to stimulate their minds and hearts, we wouldn't be in the mess that we're in. And so we are instructed to keep our hearts with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. By laying there, sometimes thinking that it might be my last ride, while laying there, God was able to get my attention in his green pastures so that I might know that he is a God who will never, ever let us down, nor will he fail us. And I think we would do well to stop and pay some attention to the heart, the center of our being. If the heart is not right, he says, you can't, it's impossible to put away a forward mouth, perverse lips. You can't do away with it if the heart is not right. And I'm glad today to report to y'all that God lifted me up in my despair, and he lifted me up, say, along with the psalmist, to a high place where I could see his goodness, his mercy, his grace. And if you want your heart fixed, he's well able to fix it. He's a master surgeon. He can cut out all of that stony stuff and give us a heart of flesh. I'm grateful to report to y'all today that in our green pastures, God will clean out some stuff. Pride. Bible says pride comes before the fall. And a lot of folk are hung up on themselves and living prideful lives. I mean negative pride. The kind of pride that will have you strutting around other saints like Satan did in heaven, thinking that he ought to be elevated above the one who created him. Pride comes before the fall. And a lot of folk need some heart fixing. And they won't allow the Lord to come in. Unforgiving spirits. He says, if you won't forgive others, how can you expect me to forgive you? Some folks just find it difficult in their pride to find a place for forgiveness in their hearts. No matter what's done to you, you need to learn how to forgive. And in green pastures, the Lord can eliminate pride and give you a forgiving spirit in place of that unforgiving spirit. Somebody else said he will move all fear, all doubts. He'll get rid of it. But you got to let him in. He says, I stand at the door and knock. If anybody open up the door and let me in, I'll come in and I'll sup with them. We'll have good fellowship. And so I'm grateful to report to y'all today, not only did the Lord fix my heart as it relates to pride and unforgiveness and fear and doubt, but he renewed my servant spirit. I wish I had somebody in here now. These nurses and these doctors, they march together hand in hand. And I remember giving out some awards to some of the folk who helped me, some of the people, the nurses and technicians that served me. While up there in ICU, they kept on serving. One shift after another, they just kept on serving. And one nurse said to me, don't worry, Pastor. God is just, he's just recharging your battery. And I'm starting to believe that. Because there's something on the inside. When God works on you, he works on the inward parts. He says anybody can clean up the outside, but I'm glad that God looks on the inside. It's not what goes in a man that defiles him, but it's what comes out. In that place, he renewed my servant spirit. I always said that I'm a servant leader, but he let me know what true service is all about. It's about sacrifice. It's about being on your watch when it's time for you to be on your watch. It's about being willing to wash feet. And I don't mean that in a literal sense, but I mean, if it takes that, whatever it takes for me to serve humankind, then I want to serve him. And so I say to you today, if you hadn't been there, keep living. And he will lay you down in green pastures. I say along with David, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. O rapture sings that wait the day when thou shalt call me home, when I shall here no longer stay, no longer weep and moan. Good evening, children. If you're serving the God that I serve, every now and then you're going to have to lay down in his green pastures. Can I get one witness here? If y'all don't mind, stand on your feet and shout hallelujah. 5 days in ICU. 5 days of toil. 5 days of struggle. But when I came out of there, I was better than I was when I went in. Let me extend the invitation for Christian discipleship. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, but thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. My sheep, he said, my sheep know my voice, and another they will never ever respond to. Can you personalize it today? Can y'all help me say it? The Lord is my shepherd. Amen. You can stop right there. Amen. Amen. If you're here and you don't know the Lord, we invite you to come to know him. Come and we'll introduce you to him. He's calling for all of those that are unsaved. And if you're outside of the ark of safety, you've been born again, we invite you to come. You can come by letter, Christian Experience. But first and foremost, we invite those to come that don't know him. He says, come, professing me before men, believing in your heart that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, died for our sins, and rose for our salvation. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Amen. Amen. All right, deacons, we can make ready now.
Jesus is my
privilege it is to be able to talk to him and tell him stuff he already know. But he wants you to, he wants it to come out of you. He wants it to come out of a pure heart. What a privilege it is. The juxtaposition of the kingdom is that we have pain, we have to cry, we have trials. But if you stop reading there, you'll be confused, because we have so much in Scripture that's paradoxical. It's almost contradictory. But when you keep reading, you'll find out that after the trials, after the tribulations, he tells us to be of good cheer. Now, how can that happen? How can I be of good cheer with all of this happening to me, happening around me? He says, because I have already overcome the world. That's good news. Whatever you need, God's got it. But you have to be willing to receive it. And learn how to give. I'm not talking about money. Life is hard. Give. Even if you're not receiving, give. For it is more blessed to give than to receive. Think about that. If you want to be happy, make somebody else happy. If you want a friend, show yourself friendly. If you want to be loved, love somebody else. And my prayer today is that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we all learn to give.
We again thank you for tuning in to our worship service at Union Chapel Missionary Baptist Church, located at 315 Winchester Road in Huntsville, Alabama, under the leadership of Dr. Owendell Davis. May God continue to bless you and your family, and we pray that our worship experience was a blessing to you.